jolly good. Hey, hello everybody, my name is Good Boy, and welcome to a video on Broodmother. What you can do to, well, win your games in 20 minutes or less. Anyway, before we begin, like, subscribe, share, and hit that glorious notification bell. Do that, I love it. Okay, so, let's talk about the meta and Broodmother. So, generally, Broodmother right now, in the meta, kinda sucks. 44% win rate. That's fairly awful. But here's a very interesting statistic you may not know. While Broodmother has a 44% win rate in the general Joe average meta, that is not the case in the pro scene. In the pro scene, in higher skill brackets, in Divine and Immortal ranks, Broodmother actually has a 54% win rate, making it one of the best heroes. In fact, the hero is so good, is in the top 10 best heroes in the higher skill brackets to be picked right now. Now, here's the interesting thing about Broodmother. The pick rate is exceptionally low, about 2% or so. And that is something that is very, very telling about a hero that has a low pick rate, but a high win rate. But I'll get onto that slightly later on in the video. So, what's happened to Broodmother, and why is it now that she's rising completely out of control? So, she's been buffed, and buffed pretty much since 7.20D, where her movement speed was improved. Agility gain has been improved in 7.21, 7.21C, and not to mention her talent tree is getting keep leveled up and improved, so much so now that at level 15, her left talent gives her increased agility bonus by 20. 20 improved agility on an agility-based hero. That's pretty insane if you think about what that does to a hero. So, generally, the hero is seeing some serious upgrades. But, why is it in the lower skill brackets she's trash, and in the higher skill brackets she's amazing? Now, obviously, people can talk about skill differences, and that is definitely a thing, but actually, that 2% pick, bearing in mind that every other top 20 or even top 30 heroes being picked in the skill bracket has a higher pick rate than Broodmother, there is something very, very special. Drafting Broodmother is the golden rule. And let me tell you about exactly what that golden rule means. You should never, ever, ever draft Broodmother unless you literally have Broodmother as the last pick. And when I say last pick, I don't mean the last pick in your team. I mean the last pick, full stop, in the game. And here's why. Broodmother is one of the most easily countered heroes in the game and will be absolutely trashed by a wealth of different heroes with the right kind of abilities. So let's just go through a couple of heroes. The number one by far, in like just a horrific cancer way, is Earthshaker. Ideally, you'd ban Earthshaker from the start, but you know, if not, just make sure they haven't drafted it and then you're fine. If you see an Earthshaker, don't play Broodmother, okay? That is just the rule. It's like a golden rule of life. Don't pick Broodmother into Earthshaker, ever. Ever. So Earthshaker's ultimate ability will basically wipe out Broodmother and her entire horde of spiderlings without any problems at all. Not to mention, of course, is that if other teammates push with you at the same time, they will all die as well, because the combination of everyone together allows Earthshaker's ultimate to deal thousands upon thousands of magical damage. Everyone will die. So don't do it. But also other heroes with large AoE, clear, and lots of damage. So Axe, for example, with his counter helix, Legion Commander, Monkey King, Alchemist, Conker even with his boat and his torrents and stuff. Any hero with large amounts of AoE, nuking damage, should just be avoided like the plague. Don't do it! Don't do it, especially if it's persistent damage or lots and lots of stacks of damage, for example. Alright, you will get trashed, they will burn you into the ground, and you will die. Now, moderate levels of board clear, or like one hero with a little bit of it, but then the rest not having the same, that's fine. But any kind of hero or significant lineups with significant AoE damage, especially if it's persistent, just say no and play a different hero. So what's happening in the pro scene is they look at the draft, they're thinking, right, I'm going to pick last, what do I pick? Oh, look at this lineup, they can't do anything really to resist my massive horde of spiderlings. I'm going to pick Broodmother. And then what happens? They dominate the game and win. So drafting is key. If you can get the drafting right, you're kind of halfway there. But let's now jump into the other half of the approach. How on earth do you play this hero, and what should you do exactly? Well, first rule, of course, is play Broodmother mid. Don't play her offlane. I know you're thinking about doing it. It kind of makes sense to do it. Don't. You will not get the farm or levels or the items, for that matter, to get what you need. It's very easy to get rotated and ganked upon. You'll be underleveled, blah, 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 blah. It's too easy to go wrong. Mid is a much safer option. It's easier for Broodmother to quickly and easily resist ganks mid. It's faster for Broodmother to get online. And it's also very easy for Broodmother to solo kill somebody, especially with her spiderlings. In the off lane, there's too much interference and stuns and disables and just starts to become a complete nightmare. So in the end, what happens? It's very simple. You just put a mid, and if you put a mid, you start getting your win rate up. And that straight away, friends, by drafting and going mid, has straight away given you a above 50% chance of winning with the hero. But there's still more and further to dive into. So let's talk itemizations. You're going to rush a soul ring. Why? Because Broodmother has massive mana issues, and you want to spam a huge number of spiderlings. After your soul ring, you might want to get power treads. Power treads stands to reason, although I have seen games where people just don't actually pick boots at all because she's so fast within her webs and she pretty much sticks exclusively to her webs. So that's fine. After that, it's all about pushing items. Items or armor shredding items. Items like Medallion of Courage, for example, can work pretty well. But the one that stands out most by far is a Desolator. Desolator gives you easily one of the best win rates because with the smashed, reduced armor of towers or enemy heroes, those spiderlings' physical damage starts to get completely ridiculously out of control and people die. The other big one, of course, is Boots of Travel, allowing Broodmother to easily and safely move across the map with large numbers of spiders, making it difficult for enemies to hunt her down and kill her. Not to mention, of course, you can hide in the woods while you're waiting, so that's, you know, all good fun. With that in mind, your game strategy is actually pretty straightforward. Max out your Q and W and skip the other two abilities. Don't get incapacitating bite until the end, and don't even get your ultimate until you've maxed out both your spinning your webs and your summoning your spiderlings. Those are the key strategies to winning the game. Now, if you can synergize with other heroes, it's even better. They also have pushing abilities, or for example, can attack enhance you. So Lycan's an excellent pusher. That's a great hero to do with Broodmother. But even without, it doesn't massively matter. The key thing is that you are forming a giant army of spiders. And then with conservative, safe play, where you pay attention to the map and look out for rotations, because Broodmother can be easily ganked and killed because she's kind of squishy, and even nukes tend to do quite well against her, then you are going to fly ahead. And in particular, you'll secure towers, and you'll secure towers pretty quickly. After you have secured your key core items, and maybe a Desolator, or even before a Desolator, a BKB will help protect you from being killed and help you get out of some seriously dangerous trouble. So that's kind of the lay of the land there. Then the strategy is pretty straightforward. Once you've summoned an entire horde of your spiderlings, you need to look out for one other key thing, what your team is doing. When your team is pushing, then you can aggressively push. Maybe they'll help you. You can push as a whole five with Broodmother, but it's a little bit better if they push another lane. You maybe tell them to push another lane, and then when they do it and the enemy team has to respond to it, or maybe they won't, then you can move very successfully forward with Broodmother and take out a tower in seconds. You do this a couple of times, you're straight away getting onto their tier 3, and you can even take out Rax. And it is literally that straightforward and simple. But remember, game setup is so important, and that's kind of the key thing you want to get right with Broodmother. Is if you get your draft right, your position right, and then with some pretty consistent and stable farm, and paying attention to the map, you can actually end games in less than 20 minutes. And it's pretty sick. So there's Broodmother. That's how you do it. Try it out and see what you think. Thank you so much for watching. Please give the video a like, subscribe, and share. Stay tuned for more great stuff coming soon. Goodbye.